David, I got a phone call here from someone who's asking a question that I actually want the answer to, because we have four small kids and my wife and I, we have a hard time getting out of the house. Listen to this question.
Hi, this is Callisto. Thank you for taking my call. I know it's important to continue dating your spouse, but our children have been getting into a lot of trouble at school, and my husband and I can't find the time because we're constantly worried about leaving them without supervision. If you could just give me some insight on this, that would be great. Thanks. Goodbye.
Bye. Thanks. Great question.
Well, gosh, Callisto, that is a great question, and one that, I hesitate to try to troubleshoot a specific thing because I know that there's all sorts of complicating factors when it comes to childcare and being able to leave your spouse, but leave your kids unattended. But I think you're right to say that it is important to continue dating your spouse. I would say that. I think that sometimes we can. There are seasons in life where we have to put our focus elsewhere. The very fact that you'd be asking this question is probably evidence of a tremendous love for your husband, and I think that you could stick with that, however possible.
Do you think, David, that we actually this is another place where? Because I'm asking the same question that Callisto, that Callisto's asking here. But it occurs to me, given what you've been saying, that maybe I'm asking that question because I really do want to keep, the home fires burning. But it could also be, couldn't it, that there's this thing called dating your spouse, which is a law, and I have to fulfill that law in order to feel like I'm justified before my spouse.
Yes, I think that you can get into, and Callisto, you probably have.
No, I'm not saying she is. I'm just saying.
No, no. But well, I think that you can. There is a cultural expectation that a marriage has to look a certain way, and that unless that you are completely passionate and again in every conceivable way, that you're somehow failing, that you're falling short. And so how do we figure out what is real here of my own desire to be with my husband or my spouse, and what is maybe the cultural telling me that I need to conform to some idea of marriage, when in fact, you know, we believe that even in the worst of circumstances, that God is your rock, and not rather than your performance as the perfect wife or perfect husband.
When you think like that, can you say, look, we don't actually have to have a date night. We can actually enjoy God's goodness to us in giving us these children together, and maybe lay on the couch together and eat pizza and watch a movie. We don't have to make dinner reservations and do, you know, get all dressed up, and actually doing this together is kind of sexy.
Yeah, I mean, I think that you're not, I would agree. There's, you know, and the more guilt we feel about somehow not living up to, the funny thing is usually both of them feel guilty about not going out more often, and that guilt is kind of keeping them from actually connecting. Mm-hmm. And they're right there. You're right there with your spouse. And so, you know, what the seasons change. And I think that there can be all sorts of release from these, you know, burdensome, sometimes cultural, or even the church puts this on people too. Let's face it, measurements that we're checking boxes that have very little to do with actually loving the person who God has put in your life. Mm.